probably be loud enough for recording, but not for singing. Like, no, no, no.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Sabbath. This church is really full this morning. Amen. I just want to thank God for this beautiful morning because, you know, as you all know, we've had, you know, kind of a tough weather and it was really bad yesterday. So thank God for this beautiful morning and that it's not raining or it's sunny outside. Amen. I just want to read something to you this morning that I thought was really fitting for today. And it's found in Patriarchs and Prophets, and it says, "Music was made to serve a holy purpose, to lift the thoughts to that which is pure, noble, and elevating, and to awaken in the soul devotion and gratitude to God." So this morning, we're going to have a lot of music from different academies, and I really hope that it blesses you this morning and that you're thankful to God for the many talents that we have in this room. And I'm also thankful that God made it possible that we're all here and that we can be here at Music Festival this year. So please, if you would, bow your heads with me so we can pray to God. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this beautiful morning, and thank you again for bringing these students here so that we can praise you. And I pray that their nervousness or the anxiety that is here this morning will go away and that we will just be calm and praise you this morning. Thank you that you protected us through the storm these couple past days, and I pray that the following program will go smoothly and that it will be a blessing to not only the students, but everyone that has come this morning. In your precious name, amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. Sabbath is a day for remembering, amen. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. The Sabbath calls to our thoughts nature and brings us into communion with the Creator. A song of the bird. Hopefully you got to listen to the birds this morning. And the sighing of the trees, the music of the sea. We may still hear his voice who talked with Adam in Eden in the cool of the day. And as we behold his power in nature, we find comfort. For the word that created all things is that which speaks to the soul. He who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. It was this thought that awoke the song from Psalms. For you, Lord, have made me glad through your work. I will triumph in the works of your hands. O Lord, your works are great. Your thoughts are very deep. Our thoughts. Gratitude and praise. And the opposite of gratitude and praise is murmuring. And if you look at the Hebrew word for murmur, it is loon. Loon. Ooh, the lunacy. Oh my goodness. Now research has shown that there is an elevation in mood when we gratitude, when we are grateful, when we praise. And so the opposite would be true then, right? If we are murmuring, if we are complaining, if we are grumbling. But the opposite that we need to gravitate towards is praise and worship. The sanctuary was meant for praising. The Sabbath is a palace in time, and therefore the sanctuary is a palace for praising. Let us praise together as we listen and worship with our guests this morning. Amen.
Good morning. We are a chunk of our students from our junior high band from Spring Valley Academy, which is located in Centerville, Ohio. It's our pleasure to be here down here for the conference. We're having a good time for the festival. We're going to play this morning a piece called African Marching Song, which is based on the African hymn Siahamba.
Thank you. the Father of lights to shine on you. And ask the Father of lights to shine on you, on you. And if the Lord alone, is lifted up, He will draw all men.
that music to our ears. Amen. Oh, that phrase, music to my ears, it evokes an emotion, does it not? We feel it. We feel it. It's something pleasant, gratifying. It's beautiful. When we hear or discover something, it is music to our ears. And Mrs. White talks of that very thing as she describes Nathaniel, his first expression of faith, so full and earnest and sincere, fell like music to the ears of Jesus. To the ears of Jesus, our faith falls like music on his ears. You know, as an Adventist community, we have the privilege of starting our music education young. Amen? Amen. And I think lots of us, particular moms, I know I even created a music ministry just in utero. I would put earphones on my stomach. Now, don't tell Sam and Maddie this. But I would put it on my stomach to listen to classical music to help cultivate that love of music. And I think it did kind of do something. We start young, and we want it to go to the very last of our days. God created us to be musicians, and rightly so. Music forms a part of God's worship in the courts above. And we should endeavor in our songs of praise to approach as nearly as possible to the harmony of the heavenly choirs. Proper training of the voice is an important feature in education, and it should not be neglected. And by all proofs showing this morning, it is not being neglected. Singing as a part of religious service is as much an act of worship as prayer. Amen? Prayer. And get this. The heart must feel the spirit of the song to give it right expression. Feel the spirit of the song. In fact, did you know your heartbeat mimics the music you're listening to? It mimics it. It goes along with it. Wow. Even in music therapy, if you've ever studied about music therapy, you can see that music helps in so many ways. It helps cardiac issues, it helps depression, it helps autism, it even helps Alzheimer's. It helps with coping in so many ways. We can see how it lifts spirits. It elevates our mood. It can decrease pain, anxiety, fatigue. If you need a boost, just listen to some good music, some hymns. How great is our God that he would give us something that helps us in all areas of our well-being. All areas. Well, let's welcome our next group of guests and enjoy all areas.
Good morning, church. Good morning. My name is Juan Hernandez, and for today I'm going to be playing the Holy City. So, all for the honor and glory of God. Thank you.
Praise him from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Did you know the doxology is our call to praise? In fact, if you look at the word doxology, it comes from Greek. It's made of the word doxa, which means to honor or glory, and logia, which means language or speak. So, glory speak, amen? Glory speak. Music has its own language, does it not? It transcends cultures, places, geography, peoples. It speaks. Music speaks, and in countless languages, the doxology is treasured. Every week, you can hear the doxology being sung, treasured by voices across the world. And as we continue in praise together, may our praises in our hearts and our minds go up and speak glory.
Happy Sabbath. I have enough voice to just introduce us. We're from Greenville Adventist Academy in Greenville, Tennessee, and we're just so blessed to be here. We are presenting three musical pieces. The first one is called The Promised Land, and that will feature our senior choir with two of our accompanists. And then we have a trumpet trio called Power in the Blood, and hopefully you'll recognize that wonderful hymn and this spirited arrangement. That's all I'll say about that. And the final piece will be from our vocal octet. Right now, we only have seven. So if you count and you say she can't count, we have eight. We just have one sick student. And if you could just say an extra prayer for him, he hasn't been feeling his best. But we do have our special conductor, Bill Toonstudy, who will be conducting us. So we're so blessed. So we hope you enjoy this music.
in 1738, Charles Wesley wrote these beautiful words, "And can it be that Christ died for me? Amazing love. How can it be?"
Father's throne above, so free, so infinite his grace, emptied himself of all the love, and bled for Adam's helpless race. His mercy all immense and free.
times, gotta find the strength to rise from the ashes and make a new beginning. Anyone can feel the ache. You think it's more than you can take, but you're stronger, stronger than you know. Don't you give up now, the sun will soon be shining. You gotta face the clouds to find the silver lining. I've seen dreams that move the mountains. Hope that doesn't ever end, even when the sky is falling. I've seen miracles just happen. Silent prayers get answered. Broken hearts become brand new. That's what faith can do. It doesn't matter what you've heard. Impossible is not a word. It's just a reason for someone not to try. Everybody's scared to death. When they decide to take that step out on the water, but it'll be alright. Life is so much more than what your eyes are seeing. You will find your way if you keep.
Good morning, everyone. We are Highland Academy. We have two songs for you this morning. We're going to sing No More Night and In the Name of the Lord. Happy Sabbath.
Evil is the new.
Wow. Is your heart not full this morning? Thank you. Each one has been such a blessing. It's been so beautiful. It makes my heart sing. Then sings my soul. Amen. As we close this morning, I want to draw us back to the theme for this weekend. It's so fitting. It encapsulates all that we are hearing and what we heard last night from our beautiful musicians by our students. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. This song prompted me to look behind the story of this song, which I want to share with you just for a moment as we close together. How Great Thou Art is a Christian hymn based on an original Swedish hymn in 1885 by Carl Boberg, entitled, O Story Good. Hopefully I pronounced that correctly. But Stuart Hines was a British Methodist missionary who was on a mission trip in the Russian Ukraine in 1931. Now follow with me on this. This kind of gets a little tricky. When he heard the Russian translation of the German song inspired by the Swedish poem, Hines began to translate the song into English and added several verses. Now, the third verse was inspired by the conversion of the villagers in Russia who cried out to God loudly as they repented. Now, repent means to turn back, do a 180, as they realized God's love and mercy. Here's that line. And when I think that God, his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I can scarce take it in. I can scarce take it in. Can you scarce take it in? Amen. And then after Stuart Hine and his family left Ukraine, as famine and World War II began and they settled in Somerset, Britain, he continued to serve as a missionary to Polish refugees. And here's where our fourth stanza comes in. Of how great thou art, inspired by displaced Russians who experienced great loss, no doubt. And they looked forward to seeing their loved ones again. Let me remind you what it says. When Christ shall come with a shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart? Then sings my soul. Music has a way, doesn't it? It has a way, expressing so much, a story within God's big story, the great controversy. I can't wait for the day when we get to all together live out John's vision in Revelation. It says, then before his wondering vision, Mrs. White says, were opened the glories of heaven, he was permitted to see the throne of God and looking beyond the conflicts of earth to behold the white robe thronged with the redeemed. He heard the music of the heavenly angels and the triumphant songs, just like we've listened to this morning. The triumphant songs of those who had overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Oh, we all can look forward to that great day. Let us praise and continue to worship God as we finish our time together this morning. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you have been with us, and no doubt can our lips, our hearts, our whole being cannot help themselves but praise you for your goodnesses and mercies that are new every morning and for eternity. May we continue to glory speak through all of our days and bring us home soon. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.